20 healthy habits that teach you how to be happy, healthy, and successful.
Hi, nurturers. Pernell here with Nurture in Christ. And if you are new to this channel, welcome. I am passionate about making videos that encourage you, that remind you of God's love. And as a mother, I love to share my experiences with my children in a way that's honest and genuine, because I know it's hard. And a lot of these people out there try to pretend it's easy, and it's not. So I try to share experiences with my children, with my husband, with all the things that we're doing. So homeschooling, cooking, laundry, cleaning, organizing, all the things that I do in my life and things that I've learned over the last 6 years now. We have a 5-year-old, 4-year-old, 1-year-old, and a baby on the way. So I try to share things that have worked for me, things that have helped to make my life easier, and things that have been a blessing to me in a way that encourages you and just motivates you to know that you can get through this, and we can get through this together as we encourage each other in life. So if you're interested in videos that, you know, show real life and that encourage moms, then make sure you subscribe to this channel. Make sure you hit this notification bell so that you don't miss any messages or any videos that I post, and give this video a thumbs up if you like what you see. Today's video will be all about productive habits and like healthy habits, healthy things that we can do that will increase our joy, that will increase our productivity, and that will help us to have a better 2021. A better 2021, because 2020 was kind of crazy, right? So I pray that this video is a blessing to you, and let's dive right into the tips. All right, so the very first tip that I want to start, this is a healthy habit that can help increase your productivity, is to block schedule. Block scheduling in essence means scheduling blocks of time throughout your day where you're able to schedule what you want to get done and then do them in those blocks. So from 8:30 to 12 every single day, it's just homeschooling. I'm not trying to answer Facebook posts or be on Instagram or making YouTube videos. I'm just spending time homeschooling our children from 8:30 to 12 every single day. From 12 to 2 or 3 o'clock, I'll use that time to do laundry, to cook, to clean, to do whatever else I want to do. And if the children are watching TV, if they're taking a nap, if they're playing, I feel no mom guilt because I've done what I need to do from 8:30 to 12. I go hard reading, singing, teaching, doing everything I can to make sure that I'm investing in them and nurturing them in that block. Block number 2, 3, 4, 5 can be whatever you want. It's just make sure that you prioritize and do what's most important with your children first. So another healthy habit that can help you to be a lot more productive and spend less time stressed out or trying to figure things out is to meal prep or batch cook. So I'll explain what I mean. When I'm, for example, going to cook chicken, I will buy a whole big old slat of chicken. It'll be like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, like the Sam's Club Costco size, like 6 boneless, skinless chicken breasts. And then I will cut all of it up. I will season all of it. And then I'll bag half of it in, or I usually do it in thirds because our kids don't really eat too much. So I'll put it in thirds. So I'll do two pieces in 1 gallon size Ziploc bag, another 2, bam. And then I'll cook the next 2, chop it all up, season it, and cook the next 2. So that's 3 meals that are all prepped and ready to go in one sitting. Another thing that I do is meal prep in terms of like the week. So what do I need? What am I gonna be feeding my family for the week? Buy all those groceries on the weekend and then start to prep it. And that way you're not at the last minute every single day trying to figure out what's for dinner. All right, so this next healthy habit is a game changer, and it will literally change your life. And it is, drum roll, 3. Pick 3 goals. 3, not 10, not 20. Even though you have a bunch of things on your to-do list, just pick 3 things for the day. Every single day, pick 3 things that you need to get done, and then go hard to get those things done. So if it means that you need to pay a bill, pay that bill. Do it first thing in the morning. If another goal is that you wanted to cook, you need to cook that day. And when I say cook, I mean like batch cook. So cook enough that can last for 2 or 3 days. Even double it so that you can freeze some and won't have to cook for another 2 days. Those 2 goals, and then the 3rd one can be something like whatever you have on your list. Fold and put away the laundry that's been sitting on your couch for a week. Those 3 things, if those are on your to-do list, then do them. Don't let anything stop you, not tiredness, not whatever. Don't let anything stop you from accomplishing those 3 goals. Not only will you feel more productive, and not only will you feel accomplished at the end of the day that you got those 3 things done, but if you accomplish it and then you have more time and energy, bam, you can add some more things in there. Why not? So another healthy habit for 2021, which is honestly, it's important for life, is to clean up. Cortisol, which is the stress hormone that our bodies create, it can mess up your sleep, it can cause you to eat more, it can just devastate your whole whole system. It just messes you up. Research has proven that that is way higher in people that have cluttered or messy homes as opposed to people that don't. It's much lower in people that don't. So I encourage you, if your house is messy, to clean up. Yes, it can feel maddening that you spend so much time and energy cleaning up and then your children mess it up like within seconds. But you gotta teach them how to clean up after themselves. That's something that we're working on. It's a habit that is learned. So teach your children to clean up after themselves. You start cleaning up after yourselves, and honestly, you'll find yourself a lot less stressed out and a lot more peaceful and joy-filled. So another healthy habit that can help you not only feel more productive, but have more energy and just be overall healthier is to exercise. I don't love exercising. I really don't. Not the traditional type of exercise anyway. However, when I do it, I feel so good about myself. Not only do I feel accomplished, but I have a lot more energy. I sleep better. And honestly, I just feel better about myself. Like, yeah, I accomplished something that I don't love, but I pushed myself and I did it. So I started walking on the treadmill for 2021. And it feels so good just to feel like I'm back on the exercise, you know, routine, the exercise thing. At some point, I would love to run a marathon or, you know, do something outrageous and ambitious like that. But exercise, if you're not into exercise like me, maybe you can just walk. Maybe you can, especially if you live somewhere cold like I do, or maybe you can do yoga every day. I'm pregnant, very pregnant, so I can't go crazy, but walking and stretching and even some yoga are beneficial. The game changer for me, other than showering every day, brushing my teeth and getting dressed, doing my hair and just making sure that I'm not in pajamas all day, the game changer has been waking up and first thing before I brush my teeth or do any of that stuff, before I exercise or talk to anybody or do anything, I spend time with God. I read my Bible, I read a devotional every single day, and I get on my knees and I pray. I'm not doing the hurried in the shower prayer or praying while I'm, you know, brushing my teeth. Dear God, thank you so much for a wonderful day. Or, you know, just the before the eating prayer where I'm just like, thank you God for this meal. Please bless us and have a great day. No, I get on my knees and actually spend like intentional time. I worship you, God, for creating me. Thank you for this world. Thank you for X, Y, and Z. Thank you for your love, your mercy, your grace. Thank you for salvation. Thank you for like just talking to him. And then I'll even try and spend as long as I can of quiet just so I can hear if he speaks back to me. I can hear him. If I'm so busy rushing throughout the day and not spending time with him, how can I hear him? So I'll spend time with God. If you are tired all the time, it is hard to feel joy and to feel productive. Instead, most of us feel stressed out, overwhelmed, and angry or grumpy if you're tired. So another productive, healthy habit is to get more sleep. And this means for a lot of us that we need to go to bed earlier. And it's hard because after a long day of childcare and work and chores and doing all the things that life requires, you're like, I just want me time. I just want to sit down or lay down and watch TV for a couple hours and kind of veg out and not talk to anyone or hear anyone call my name and ask for anything. However, if you're watching TV for 2-3 hours and going to bed at 11 o'clock or 12 o'clock and having to get up, you know, at 5 o'clock or 6 o'clock, you're only getting, you know, 5-6 hours of sleep. God forbid if your child doesn't sleep through the night and you're waking up to make bottles or nurse or give breathing treatments or something, you're gonna be tired. So go to bed earlier and your body will thank you for it. You will be happy, you will be happier, healthier, and just feel more productive. So I've started this new habit. I started it probably 2 years ago of not scrolling through my phone in the middle of the night. Does it always happen? No, sometimes, you know, I'm tempted and I do it, but I'd say 99% of the time I will sleep with my phone on the couch, but we have a little love seat beside the bed and I will put my phone there and I don't touch it. It doesn't matter what time of night I wake up, I will not scroll through that phone. I have a watch that I'll hit it just so I can see the time and then bam, I go right back to sleep. Or if I'm not sleeping with my watch, then I'll look at my phone, note that, okay, it's not time to get up yet, put it right back down and go right back to sleep until it is time to get up. If you are looking at your phone throughout the night, it wakes your brain up and then it's really hard to sleep. And not only sleep, but if you read bad news, it can be upsetting and kind of just like devastate your sleep altogether. So another healthy habit is to sleep with the phone beside the bed. So when your alarm goes off in the morning, if you set an alarm, you can turn that off, but you don't need to be having your phone all up in the bed. Another healthy habit that has helped me big time with joy and peace is gratitude. There are so many times in the Bible where we're encouraged to be grateful and to express gratitude. It's a big deal, I think, not only to God, but I think to the world that we feel gratitude and that we express gratitude. So not only do people feel like we appreciate them, but also it can help us to stay positive. I'll give you a quick example. There's this sweet little boy that lives in our community that was born with like major health issues. And there's times where my children, you know, they're not sleeping through the night, or especially when Faith was a newborn, she cried a lot and was up a lot all night long. And I'd be so stressed out. And I would say, God, oh my gosh, give me the strength. And he would be like, be thankful for what you have. Be thankful that you don't have a special needs kid that's waking up multiple times a night doing breathing treatments or XYZ. Or if I'm like, well, you know, I'm sad about this, he's like, well, you can walk, you can talk, you can see, you can hear. So I'd be like, God, thank you. Thank you that I can do all these things and I have all these things. Gratitude brings joy. I know this sounds doom and gloom, but I'm gonna keep it real with you and share a secret. This is something I've been doing for years and it helps me to keep joy. A lot of people say, how do you stay so happy all the time? This is how. I pray and I ask myself, God, if you were to call me home tomorrow, like tomorrow was to be my last day on earth, would whatever I'm stressing about right now, would it matter? And if the answer is no, then I stop stressing about it. So YouTube videos, sometimes I wanna get like a video done every single day. And I'm like, oh, you know what? I wasn't able to get a video done today. If I were to die tomorrow, would it matter? No. Okay, I'm having an argument with my husband and, we're disagreeing about something and I don't want to forgive him because he was wrong and I want him to admit that he was wrong. But if I were to die today or tomorrow, or he were to die today or tomorrow, would it matter? No, so forgive and get over it. Or my kid is asking for one more hug or one more story and I really want them to just be quiet and go to bed. But if they were to die tomorrow, would it matter? So read that book, right? Just read that book. Right? If you were to die, would it matter? Another healthy habit for 2021 that can help increase your productivity is to be more present. So ask yourself, when you're spending time with your children, when you're reading to them or they're reading to you, are you actually like listening to what they say with intentionality? Are you nodding? Are you smiling? Are you engaged? Do you know what they look like when they're talking about something that excites them and brings them joy? Are you like, wow, are you serious? That's so awesome. Like, are you talking or are you just like, yeah, okay, yeah. Okay, all right, go play. Sometimes we can get frustrated because it's so overwhelming. Like, mom, can I have something to eat? Can I have this? Can I do this? Can we do this? You're constantly being pulled in every direction, especially if you have a lot of children and a lot of responsibilities and you're trying to juggle a million balls. You just want, shut up. You just want to be like, everyone to be quiet. But if you can pause and be intentional and present in what you're doing, you'll feel a lot more joy and peace and rest. Another healthy habit for 2021 that can help you not only boost productivity, but to help you just feel better about life is to stop wasting time on social media. And I'm preaching to the choir here because I can find myself scrolling on Facebook, Instagram, TikTok, all the different platforms for unbelievable and kind of embarrassing amounts of time. So I am going to go ahead and restrict myself and only allow myself to maybe have like maybe 20 minute increments, maybe like two or three times a day. 20 minutes times three will give me like one whole hour of scrolling. And that may seem like a lot to you, but for me, I can easily add up the amount of time to be like, okay, I spent a good 3 hours throughout the day. When I add 20 minutes here, 30 minutes here, 5 minutes here, it adds up quickly. And honestly, I could be using that time to pursue my own dreams. And instead of like helping other people reach their own goals, I can help myself reach my own, right? And have a little bit more rest as well. Another healthy habit that can help you to live a more peaceful, productive life and just to be more filled with joy and hope for 2021 is to cut off negativity from your life. That means don't talk to anyone or socialize with anyone that is a downer or a one-upper. That means if you say, hey, my kid, you know, did X, Y, or Z today and they're so great, they're like, oh, well, my kid, da-da-da-da-da. Or if someone, for example, dies, they're like, oh my gosh, I knew that person and I, this and I'm so sad and I there's some people that are so narcissistic and so self-absorbed that they can't really see past themselves. And when you're talking about yourself, it's just like negativity or criticism. They don't make you feel good about yourself. They make you feel drained and sad and like you're either not doing good enough in life or they just don't make you feel good about yourself. Cut those people off or just distance yourself from them. And that includes social media posts. Get away from comparing yourself to other people. It's sickening and it's not healthy. Another healthy habit for 2021 to have a more productive and joy-filled life is to create the life that you want for yourself. And that means having a little bit more control. So for me, We started virtual school with our kindergartner in September, and very quickly, like in the first 2 weeks, we realized that this is ridiculous and not working for us at all. One of the children would be crying for me, another kid would be, you know, asking me to read a book, and the whole time I'm like, shh, we have to be quiet, it's computer time, and then we're on the computer, then off the computer, then we're logging on, then we're logging off, and it was just crazy. We couldn't go anywhere, we couldn't do anything. It was just horrible. So I said, you know what, this is not working. We pulled her out of school and I decided to become a homeschool mom, something that I know many of you have done this year. And it's stressful. It was stressful, but now I'm happy and we feel like there's balance and there's peace and everyone's learning and everyone is on our schedule. We're not on the school schedule. So that's something that I did that I feel more peace and joy. You got to do what works for you. Another healthy habit that can help increase your productivity and your joy is to create the life that you need. That means healthy boundaries. So not having anyone that's toxic or speaking negatively in your life. There's power in the tongue, there's power in everything we say. So that means even you not being negative about yourself. So like if you do something dumb, don't say, oh, I'm so stupid or I'm so dumb. Just be like, you know what? I made a mistake, whatever. On to the next. I'll make a better decision next time. If someone in your life is talking junk or dogging your kids or your spouse or your whoever or dogging you or just being negative and critical, distance yourself with that person. Find a way to form healthy boundaries. You may not need to cut someone off altogether. If that doesn't work for you, if it does, go with it. But if it doesn't work for you, then just find, you know, spaces to say, you know what, I'm gonna only allow this person to speak life. And if they start talking negative or talking junk, I'm just gonna find a way to exit the conversation to be like, oh, I just realized, I just remembered I have an appointment, or I need to go, I'll talk to you later, blah, blah, blah. Just surround yourself with peace and joy. So 2020 was absolutely crazy. We found out about this new COVID coronavirus and we entered into a pandemic. With that came this quarantine where people weren't able to get out and see friends, family, relatives, go to school, do anything. And if you, God forbid, you got sick, then you were stuck in the hospital or at home for crazy amounts of time. And it's really been emotionally, physically, mentally, spiritually, financially draining on everybody. It's been really stressful. It can be hard not to look at the new stats to see like the 20 million plus now cases in USA alone and the almost 350,000 people that have died because of this virus. It can be really hard to inundate yourself with all that information and then to be in a state of peace. So give yourself 5 minutes a day just to get updates and then like, don't look up, you know, how many more new strains there are or any of that stuff. Just keep your mind on things that are peaceful, hopeful, joyful, and remain in a state of peace throughout the day so you can function productively with joy. I wanted to share another productive, healthy habit routine that I have now embraced as part of my 2021 routine just to live a healthier, more balanced lifestyle, and that's smoothies. I have jam-packed this smoothie with peaches, pineapple, blueberries, mango, banana, strawberries, and spinach. So I'm trying to jam pack as many nutrients and vitamins in here as I possibly can because I know that taking care of my 5-year-old, 4-year-old, 1-year-old, and this baby on the way, I need all the energy I can get. Every day I'm homeschooling. I'm trying to make videos for Instagram, for Facebook, for YouTube, and I'm just trying my best to be present and have as much of myself as I can to serve my family, my friends, my community. So smoothies, that's another healthy habit that you can include in your routine to give you energy and to prevent you from grabbing, you know, sugary snacks that aren't good for you anyway. So another healthy habit that can help not only increase your productivity, but just help you to feel better and healthier overall is to drink water. I will leave a link to this water bottle in the description box below, but look at this. It has 8 a.m. get started, 9 a.m. remember your goal, 10 a.m. keep chugging, 11 a.m. don't give up, 12 a.m. almost there, 1 p.m. you did it, and then refill. So this water bottle is awesome because it helps me to keep going. And honestly, I usually drink 4 of these every single day. Sometimes I'll even have 5 if it's been a day where I'm a little bit more active, but this has 32 ounces. So if your goal is to drink a gallon a day or more than that, then I highly recommend a bottle like this. There's a lot that you can find on Amazon, but I will link this one just because I love it. It's really easy to clean and, you know, it doesn't have the straw and all that, and it doesn't leak. You know, it has this pop-on lid. So water is so vital for our health and for our bodies. Drink more water. Well, I hope you enjoyed these tips and I hope that they help you to live a healthier, more productive life and that they help you to form some healthier habits, just healthy habits for a better 2021. If you enjoyed this video, please make sure you give me a big thumbs up. If you're new here, subscribe. Hi, Faith. And I hit that notification bell. It's wash day, so we're about to get our wash on. But if you are new here, make sure you hit that subscribe button and the notification bell, and we will see you in tomorrow's video. God bless you, and I pray that 2021 is your best year yet. Have a wonderful day. Bye. Before I go, I want to encourage you, please comment below and share with us what was your favorite tip, or what is something that I missed? What's a tip that you can share with this community of nurturers of something that we all can do to have healthy habits or a more productive life in 2021? Please share that below, and I look forward to reading your comments, and I'll be sure to respond to each and every one of you. Have a wonderful day, and thank you. Bye.